Yeah, how do you make sure that your rotary tables do not overheat?
Well, it's one of the most important factor here in DD rotary table. So we use, as you see here in the table, we use a KTY silicon sensor.
KTY sensor?
Oh, yeah, okay. We have it embedded inside the DD rotary table. Mm-hmm. And it's also it's a BTC kind.
PTC.
A positive temperature coefficient.
All right.
Yeah, which stands, which means in simple words, the resistance of the sensor has to be proportional to the current temperature.
Okay, got it. Now, the sensor, of course, does not directly adjust the temperature, but it's very important for temperature control. So, Sam, how exactly does this sensor help prevent your rotary tables from overheating?
Well, in simple words, the sensor will just send a feedback of the temperature to the controller, and the controller can stop the motor at any specific temperature.
Okay, so that's how it works, but I'm sure you also have to test that, right? So
absolutely.
You must follow some kind of procedure as well there?
Of course, yes. Thank you for reminding me of that. We test it according to NEMA, the Manufacturing Electric Manufacturing Association, yes.
Okay, so that's NEMA, but installation class F. You can explain it.
Now we're getting even more technical. Okay, well, it means in an environment of 40 Celsius, the allowable equilibrium.
So an environment like here feels like it.
Yeah, it's kinda, yeah.
Okay, 40
degrees Celsius. The allowable equilibrium of the rated torque increases and should be less than 105.
Okay.
And in order to reach that kind of equilibrium, I mean the temperature equilibrium, we should run the rotary table for 3 hours.
For 3 hours? Wow, that's a long time. Why 3 hours?
Well, because during the first 30 minutes, the DD rotary table temperature rises rapidly, then start to become stable. When I say stable, I mean the temperature starts rising 1 Celsius per 30 minutes.
Okay.
Yes.
So after 3 hours, it's reached the peak most of the time?
We can say so, yes.
Okay. So now let's see if I have understood what Sam has just been telling us. So if we have a surrounding temperature of, let's say, 30 degrees Celsius, and then on top of that, we add the 105 degrees that you were just talking about, then we would have an equilibrium.
135?
135 degrees,
yes.
Is that correct?
Correct, absolutely, yes.
Yes, 100 points for me, all right. But 135 degrees Celsius, that's how hot the motor gets inside your rotary tables. I wouldn't have expected that. It's so high.
Well, it's very common when it comes to the DD rotary table. As I mentioned before, during the rated torque, the DD rotary table operates continuously. So we use a robust sensor to avoid the DD rotary table from getting overheated and burning out the coil. And this is how we define the torque.